Welcome back to First Things First. On Sunday, Austin Dillon won the 60th running of the Daytona 500. He took the checkered flag after a dramatic final lap. And guess what? He is with us now, Austin.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Thanks so much for joining the show. We appreciate it.
This is great. I'm a huge sports fan, so to be on here with you guys, Hall of Famer, man, it's awesome.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
So it's great an to honor have you. For us.
Yeah. So Nick, he comes in with some respect. See that?
Yeah. He just met you today.
Young
man. And that's how I was the first time
good
I met
and
you,
decent
too.
Young man.
Okay. Yeah, it's great to see you all.
Austin, we are thrilled to have you. What was it like winning your first Daytona 500?
It was so special. Having all my family there, for my grandfather, he gave me my career, and to be able to give him a trophy back like this, it feels really great.
And people don't know who your grandfather is.
Yeah, my grandfather, Richard Childress, car owner for Dale Earnhardt. He went into the Hall of Fame in NASCAR a couple years back, and, he's been around NASCAR, just legendary, and it's been very special to be able to drive his number in the 3 car, and had a lot of fun so far, and Daytona 500, man, it was awesome.
So if people just, I mean, saw the last half hour of the race, it was crazy. And it was, as we, last year, I think the Daytona went to 5 what they called overtimes. This year we had 1. I'm not talking about at the very end, but the wreck before the last wreck, with the one that ended up putting you guys in caution, I think, with 8 laps to go. What is, as a driver, are you constantly aware, like, okay, I've got to do what I've got to do, but also, if this wreck comes, I just have to avoid it? Or are you not even thinking about that part of it?
So Daytona is like a chess match. There's a lot going on throughout that race. And the biggest thing, you can't win unless you're there at the end. You got to be there on the last lap. So my strategy throughout the race, because we were in a backup car, we started in the back, and I wanted to make it through all the wrecks and be there at the end. We ended up finishing 9th in the second stage. We go back on racing. The wreck happens. Actually, with about 11 to go, we were sitting in 13th away from the pack. And I was thinking, oh, no, our race is over. I got this clean car to race with, and I can't get to the pack. Caution comes out. We make some good strategy running up through there. The next wreck, like you're talking about, where we end up 4th, I'm thinking, oh, my gosh, we're sitting here 4th with a green-white checker to go. I'm just thinking it's going to be a good Daytona 500 no matter what. And then the opportunity comes with my buddy Bubba, who gives me a huge push down the backstretch. We use it and go to victory lane.
What does it mean to you to win in the number 3 car 20 years after Dale Earnhardt's victory?
We talked about it leading up to the race. It was a storyline, and I kind of ran with it. I was like, how special would it be to get the 3 back in victory lane 20 years later? And just dreaming about this moment and how it all comes together. Daytona, I talked about it also. It's a historical place that always has a storyline. And leaving there with the win, 20 years difference, it's very cool.
20 years ago, you were there at the finish line with your, what do you call him, Pop-Pop?
Yeah, that's
Pop-Pop
right.
there. So you've grown up around racing, historic race as far as the finish. You win in 20 years later. But also you mentioned Bubba Wallace, the first African-American on the regular NASCAR top-level circuit driver since 1971. He finished in a photo finish 2nd. What does that mean, not only for you winning and the history just of your family around racing, but Bubba winning, what it means for racing?
Well, I think it's just great for our sport. I actually grew up racing with Darrell, and we'd go racing Bandoleros, Legends cars, came up through the ranks kind of racing against each other. And Darrell's done a lot to get to this point.
Darrell is Bubba?
Yeah, Bubba, yes. Darrell
okay.
Wallace.
Yes.
So Bubba, and actually I put him, I have motorsports, Austin Dillon Motorsports, put him in a truck last year, and he won his first truck, well, not his first truck race, he run a couple, but he had won there, and it kind of came full circle getting him that truck deal to now he's at Petty Motorsports and running the 43 full time, and then he pushes me to victory lane at Daytona. It's really cool to the connection there, but for our sport it's amazing, and he's doing a great job.
Prior to when was the first moment you thought you could win, when you got the push, or did it happen before that? When, because you mentioned you're in 13th, you're like, but was it the green white checker that you realized, oh, we're going to be right there? When did you first think you could win the race?
Well, I tell you, I knew coming off of turn 2 that we were going to have a run. We were side drafting pretty hard with the 11.
Right.
And when the 43 got in my back bumper, I knew that was going to be it. If we're going to make a move, it was there. And got clear of the 11 and had a huge run. The 10 car of Eric Almirola, he put a block, and we just had too much momentum. It turned him. Ended up getting back to the start-finish line first. And it's just when that's going through your head, I'm sure like for running the touchdown for you, when it's going through your head, things are happening so fast, you're just trying to get there. And looking back, I mean, it's pretty cool how it happened.
In winning this championship, a lot of crazy things. Chris Long, he talked about getting a tattoo of a defensive line coach. We have other people, Philadelphia Eagles fans are getting tattoo of the Philly special, the play. You got a tattoo on your buttocks after. Now let me know, man, how this went down.
All right, so I'm just hanging with my guys, and I actually already had a tattoo back there. And it was just a group of my boys. We call each other the Wolf Pack, right? Yeah. And so half of my team this year were already in the Wolf Pack, and they moved up to my team. It was kind of like the joining and changing of the guard of our team. And so after the race, we ended up going to the same tattoo parlor that we went a couple years back and got a new tattoo of the Daytona 500
That's
championship
awesome.
On it.
So, That's awesome. Yeah.
It is. We know, CeCe, when you sat down, told you, enjoy, this is your moment. This is your time. But what, as I'm sure you start to look ahead, are your goals for the rest of this season?
Well, we have a lot of goals. We set out to win more than one race. We wanted to win a couple, so you can't do any better than start the race season off with a win. But my main goal for me is to become a NASCAR Cup champion. I've won two championships. I would be the first to win all three. So that would be really cool.
So you'd be the first driver ever to win all three of the different series championships.
Yes, sir. I've won the Truck Series, I won the Xfinity, and now the opportunity is there to win the Cup Series.
And you also, there's four crown jewels in your sport, right? There's the Daytona, which everyone knows about, the Coca-Cola 600, which I think people know because it's the 600, the Brickyard, which is famous because of the Brickyard, and then Southern 500. You won the Coca-Cola last year. And you won the Daytona this year, so you're halfway there as well, right?
That's right. And the first two cup wins I've got have been these crown jewel races. I just like to show up for the big ones.
That's amazing.
What's wrong with that?
I'll take it.
It's like a lot like a guy you're a fan of, Carolina Panthers fan.
That's right.
There we go.
Cam.
You're on the Cam bandwagon. What do you see for Cam and the Carolina Panthers going forward? You see a championship?
I hope so, man. I went to the Super Bowl when they went out there and just dominated all the way getting there to Super Bowl, and it just didn't look right when we got there. So I'm looking forward to the new offensive coordinator, North Turner. I want to see what he brings to the offense. Christian McCaffrey, I'm a huge fan of him too. I just want to see how they can integrate him, get him the ball more. And it's a fun offense to watch once you get rolling. The steam's there. And Luke Kuechly, he texted me after the race. That was really cool. Just huge fan of all those guys. I try and stay in touch with them when I can.
You also have another fan. Earlier when you were coming in, we did the end bump. I gave you an item that brought back some memories from before the race. Can you share with fans what happened and how it was a magical moment even before you got in the car?
I actually got to talk to this fan last night. So the story goes, I'm at an autograph session, and the kid walks up, and he's got just a regular, like,
how
hat.
Old is he?
He's probably 9, 10 years old.
Okay.
And he's just got a regular hat, no driver-affiliated hat. And I ended up handing him my hat and signed this, and I look, I gave you a hat. I better be your driver, right? And he's like, yeah, you're my guy now. I'm like, cool. So the next day I walked through the garage, ended up seeing him, and he yells at me, and I come over there because I seen him with the hat. It was one of my hats, and I was like, all right, cool. So I walk up to him, and he goes, I got something for you. And I was like, what is it? And he gave me a heads-up penny. And the story goes, Dale had a penny in his car 20 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And so we stuck that penny in the car. It actually was in my Clash car. It's the race before the 500, and we ended up having to go back home, get the penny, pull it out of there, and put it in the 500 car. So we put a little extra work in to make sure we had it in the car for the 500.
Does that go to the Hall of Fame? Does that go to you? Do you still have it? What's the story? Where is that now?
So what you do when you win Daytona, the next day they put it in the Daytona Museum. The car goes in there.
Right.
And the penny's in the car sitting there right now. You can go check it out at Daytona.
That's
unbelievable.
Awesome. That's
we awesome. So appreciate you being on here with us. Austin Dillon, Daytona 500
Congratulations,
winner.
Congratulations, man.
Thank you so Thank much. You. All right, well, we'll be back. We got more here on First Things First.
You're great.
Thank
awesome.
You so much. Now you can work on your hoop.
Yeah,
so what do you think about North Turner, though, man?
I love North. I love North. I believe that he'll help Cam more in the passing game than Schultz.
UFC Fight Night on Fox.
Thank you.